our first day on the, we call it the Kalahari Pans tour. We meet up at Sakoma. We travel through to a wild camping area over here. That is 203 kilometers. Then day two and three. Now, this area over here is the Mabua Sohubi National Park. Day two and three, we travel from here, from our wild camp, all the way up to to Car Gate, which is this area over here, which is 224 kilometers. This we'll camp here. We'll definitely have some showers and toilets for two nights, and then day three we will travel all the way up this cut line again, come through these spans, have a look at these spans, and come through here. So we'll sleep two nights over there. Day four we're gonna travel up to Namepan, which is this area over here. This road is very, very nice to travel. Sleep over there for at Namepan in the KD2 wildlife management area. Day five, we travel 185 kilometers up to Mkunsi, where we put in some fuel again. Ride up all the way. This, guys, this traveling is all the way is dirt roads and gravel roads. And we sleep over here at Masatling Pan. Very nice place to sleep as well. Lots of game and animals on it. Just let me tell you about Mkunsi quickly. We fill up there with fuel and get water there as well. Day six is 77 kilometers. We travel all the way back down here up to another bush camp over here on this cut line. Day seven, we travel from the bush camp all the way up to Kang. Here at Kang, we can sleep in chalets if you want there as well. There is a restaurant as well. And that will be our last day on the Kalahari Pan tour. So that's a 7-day Kalahari Pan tour. Then we've also got a 13-day Okovango Delta route. Day one. So let me just get there quickly. Day one, meet up at Maun. We meet and greet at Maun, where we fill up with fuel and get all our groceries and all our other necessities which we need for the rest of the tour. So day one we travel 113 kilometers right up here to the Kwai village area. We stay at Saha camp number two. We're going to drive all the way through next to the river. This road is also dirt road all the way, and all wild camping, guys. Yes, there are ablutions there. There's a donkey as well that supplies us with hot water that we need to make, and there are toilets as well. That's day one and two. Day two, let me just explain to you as well. Day two, we're also going to drive around. Let me just get to that there. Day two is 78 kilometers. We start early morning, straight after breakfast. We drive all this way over here to see game next to the Kwai River all the way. Now, this whole area here is very populated by elephants, giraffe, waterbuck, hippos, and even lion as well. So we're going to drive all the way through there like that, go through, sleep the night again at Tsar camp number two. That's day one and two. Day three, we travel through the Kwai area again on this transit road. Now, guys, this is not very easy traveling. This is quite difficult traveling. The road is thick sand, and it also gets used by trucks, so it's rutted all the way. We sleep in at a wild camp from Taha camp all the way through to this wild camp here. 74 75 kilometers for the day, but we are going to drive all day, and we definitely saw some a few times elephant definitely, and a wild dog or painted dog, like they call them these days. Day four, wild camp to Sronga, which is right on the delta. Nice Makoro drives we can take here on the boats on the whole delta over here. So this area is very, very nice. Very lucky to travel with on the Makoros as well. Day 5 and 6, we travel. That's 120 kilometers from Soronga, past Chakawi. At Chakawi, we can get some fuel again, and obviously some groceries we need to top up. Drotsky's cabins, also on the Delta, very nice place to be. You can rent a boat there to go for photography, or even rent fishing gear to go do some fishing as well. The elusive tiger fish is also around here. Very nice place to stay for 2 days to relax, hot water showers and toilets. Really like a place to be. Day 7, 63 kilometers down this piece of tar road here, which is not always very good, full of potholes, and then up to Tsodilo Hills. Tsodilo Hills, really nice place to be as well. You can rent a guide there and he can show you all the Bushman paintings. Only 1 day, 1 night sleep there, but there are toilets there as well and facilities. Day 8, 193 kilometers up back to the tar road, all the way down. Let me just zoom out a bit. All the way down to this wild camp over here. Guys, the reason we're taking this road, it's very nice driving, also thick sand, and there's a lot of animals around this whole area over here. Day 9, we travel from this wild camp up to Waksu camp, also wild camping. So that area of there is wild camping, to this wild camping over here, Waksu caves. We haven't seen any caves there yet, but apparently there are. But also elephant area, this very, very nice. Day 10, we travel from Waksu up to the old Drotsky caves. We can also rent a guide there. It's not far to go, it's only 51 kilometers, but we need to actually leave early morning to go through Nainai and Pei, and then go to the Drotsky caves. Now I'm going to try and pronounce that name, Chihaba caves as well. Very interesting, very nice tour that as well. Right, then day 11, 181 kilometers, all dirt, thick, two-spoor road to travel to our wild camp over here. Also some nice animals that we've seen on this whole route. Day 12 is at 212 kilometers, which we leave our bush camp over here and travel down to Sihitwa, where we fill up with fuel and get some cold drinks, and then go down all the way down to our Alfari camp, where we have some facilities again, running water, hot showers and toilets. And day 13, which is our last day, we travel from Alfari camp right down to Kang, again, where we've got a restaurant and we can stay in chalets, and there we meet, say our goodbyes. Guys, this is a quick preview of what we've got in Botswana going. Like I said to you, this is only very, very quick. We are going to send you an email that you can have a look at and see exactly what our tour is all about. There'll be some more videos on with photos and videos that we actually made on these tours of the bands and then of the Delta and animals as well. Thanks for joining us.
To the open sky, from the mountain top. The cross before.